Real air crew don't like us using that term because we're not actually in the aircraft. They don't even like us wearing flight suits anymore. They think we're hoses. The dynamics of what goes on personally is really strange because when the program first started, when I first got in, it was in prototype phase. It's actually just coming out of prototype. And then all of a sudden the military was just like, we need more people to do this. We actually had a high-ranking general, a four-star admiral, to see what this was about, because we wanted to do and we didn't have the high-ranking personnel that we thought, and so he was like, when he first arrived, he was like, I like this, I can see the feed live, and you know,
Fee, würdest du ihn malen?
Soll ich ihn malen?
Ob du ihn malen würdest?
Nein.
Das war ein sehr spannender Abend zum Thema Drone Strikes, die Erfahrung eines Piloten. Und ganz besonders war, dass Fee Fleck sich mit ihm unterhalten hat, hat ihn eingeladen, aufmerksam gemacht auf den Winterzyklus. Und er ist auch sehr interessiert. Jetzt schreibt sie ihm gerade eine Widmung. Sozusagen ein sehr historischer Moment.
That's what we get. That's what we get. We would take what they would call normal for the culture, action on that. So then you get the disadvantage. That's the disadvantage.
you don't have to beat someone up and steal their car from them. You don't have to go and fuck hooks. You don't have to go and do this. You can make the decision to purchase a vehicle. You can do normal human things. But because people are given a choice in that regard, it's shown that one day, 15 minutes after someone gets done playing a game like Call of Duty, they're more likely to go do something irrational and instinctual. Someone that plays a game like Grand Theft Auto or Mainz is a choice, they understand the consequences of it. They're more likely to leave that scenario and go make a more moral choice because they've already...